There we go.
That's not what you want to see, though. That's not what we expected.
We're not.
So anybody back there that can we pretend like it was connected? How would you pretend like it's connected? Is this where you go, Vicky, help?
What's that?
They're just friends. They just want to see a miracle.
Try one more.
I want to see a miracle. You want shield? You still do? Okay, I want you to pretend now. You do? Yeah, you do. We'll get it working. Are we going to try it again?
I think we need a little bit more time.
You need a little bit more time? All right, so tell you what. I am going to say a few more words, and then you take your time, okay? But fast. Now, so this is the culmination of 5 years of work across every single organization. Across every single organization that's right there, ladies and gentlemen. Let me sit back down.
See,
in just
I think
that time,
was,
you got 44
emails that were...
Stop sending us emails. You're killing us. Okay, so let's how about Most Wanted real quick?
Yeah, let's play some Need for Speed Most Wanted.
Okay, Need. Now, look, this is a GeForce GTX 680 sitting in this PC right here. We just made a connection. There's a piece of software in GFE that is now taking what is rendered by GeForce and streaming it to Shield. And it's going to be good?
It's going to be good.
Now you're sitting anywhere in the house. Your PC is in your room, and you're there sitting on the couch pretending like you're spending time with your family. You're in bed pretending to be sleeping. Or you're in some other room where you always have your mobile device. Now spin that car around. I love this car.
All right.
Is this is graphics that that Jason is currently enjoying on Shield. That's fantastic. You can't do that. So what's happening here is that Shield, the controller commands are being sent to the PC. The PC with GeForce GTX inside renders the screen, computes the next scene, and streams it back out. Over Ethernet in this particular case, but at home it'd just be over Wi-Fi. There's plenty of bit rate for that. In just a jiffy, the latency is so short, it's as if you are right there connected to the PC. You could enjoy it on your display here, or you could enjoy it connected to television. Now show me Steam. Can you show me Steam?
I can. Let's take a look.
Show me how I am going to Oh, you guys.
So, let's take a look at Assassin's Creed first, and then we'll go to Steam.
Okay.
Do that.
Assassin's Creed. The latest Assassin's Creed. Now, what's Assassin's Creed about, anyways?
So, Assassin's Creed is it's an action-adventure. You are a...
A time traveler.
You're a time traveler. Well,
right.
You time travel in an interesting way. You're from a long lineage of assassins, and uh, you travel through their memories.
Uh-huh.
There's a machine called the Animus that you can relive their memories through. And Assassin's Creed 3, you go back and visit one of your ancestors during the Revolutionary War and are trying to collect some knowledge and information to be able to avoid a global disaster.
Wow, okay. Well, who likes global disasters?
So we're going to be Desmond here.
That's amazingly beautiful. Hey, guys, what do you think about this graphics?
John and Isabella. One and the same. Your permission is with Edward Braddock, is it not?
So we just arrived in Boston here after traveling from England. And one of the cool things about this game is the free running.
Bloody hell!
So you can climb up on. Just sort of run all over the place.
The frame rate is fantastic. The interactivity looks perfect.
You can get some really beautiful
views here.
And the
best possible graphics you could put on television today. This is running on a 4K television. Wow, that's amazing. Okay, that looks great. And if we ignored all that other stuff just now, it just worked. It just worked. Wow, okay, all right.
And then of course.
So of course, Steam, I mean, boy. The number one, the most important digital game store in the world for games. Look at that. Store. Everything just works, just like those two other games. Right on. Thank you, Jason. Good job. I guess if you press things enough times, it works. And so you saw S.H.I.E.L.D. Enjoy games from two of the most important digital stores in the world, the Google App Store, Play Store, within it, a curated game store called Tegrazone. Everything you buy there on your phone, on your tablet, from your PC, using their website, just shows up on S.H.I.E.L.D. You download it, and you play it the way it's meant to be played. You could also connect to the other great store, Steam, with almost 2,000 games, with 54 million gamers. All of these gamers are now able to enjoy their Steam games from anywhere around the house, and hopefully in the future, even beyond that. And our vision is that the way you play games with these devices, because you have a screen here now, and the controller and the computer, the processors are right there inside the controller, the type of games we'll be able to enable will be very different. Imagine each one of your shields, you see the driver's cockpit view. However, everybody who's inside, they're watching you, aren't looking at the cockpit view or the split-screen view, but they're looking at a spectator view. You can imagine all kinds of different ways now to create games as a result of this kind of model. And so just to summarize what we talked about today, the consumer electronics industry has been radically, radically changed over the last 10 years. The PCs connect to mobile devices, and these digital devices have cloud services that provides for music and movies and books. And all of these devices can stream to multiple devices now and multiple screens. We wanted to, over the last 5 years, create the pieces necessary for us to do the same for video games. And so today, to summarize the things that you've seen today, this is what we've done. We created GFE, which is essentially an application that allows the end user to enjoy the game simply, but to take advantage of their full potential of their personal computer. It makes video games simple like a game console on a PC. There's a piece of software that's inside this GFE that also streams and connects it to a mobile device. This mobile device is called Shield. Now you can enjoy your PC games processed on GeForce GTX, streamed to your device anywhere in the house. This Shield also allows you to, today, connect what we showed you was HDMI, but in a very short period of time, we'll also be able to connect wirelessly, just like AirPlay, using the same technology that we showed you today, using streaming technology, to stream it to your television as well. And so you should be able to sit on your couch, and if you decide that you would like to share the movie that you're watching on your Shield on television, you simply have to beam it to your television. The television needs a receiver. It could be a smart television. It could be a OYO game console that they're working on. It could be a little dongle that is Wi-Fi to HDMI. All of these experiences are then supplemented with a cloud service made possible by Grid. Cloud services will come to us in a lot of different channels and a lot of different formats, just as cloud services today for music and TV shows and otherwise. And together, it creates the ability for us to enjoy video games on any device, at any time, at any place, and on any screen. These elements of technology has taken us quite a while to put together, and it looks like we have a little bit more work on Shield. And but I think it's going to usher in the same type of experiences that we were able to enjoy for music and movies over the cloud and in this untethered way, but now, finally, for video games. I want to thank all of you for coming today. Hope you stay around and enjoy the party with us. Thank you, everybody. Happy New Year.
We're going to transition this room and get ready for a party to which all of you are invited. We're going to move all the chairs. So what we'd like to ask you to do is to step outside through the doors to the pool. Cocktails are being served and appetizers. And in about 10 or 15 minutes, we're going to invite you back in for more food and beverage, etc. So have a great time. Thank you for coming. Please, everybody, exit out to your left towards the pool. For those of you that are up on the upper levels, the bar is open there, serving appetizers and drinks. You may stay up there and enjoy that for now. Thank you, everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, for anyone who didn't hear my announcement, for those of you that are upstairs now in the upper levels, the bar is open upstairs, so please feel free to stay and have a cocktail. There's also appetizers being served up there. Everybody else on the lower level, if you would please make your way to the left and exit out to the pool so we can get the chairs out of your way, where we're transitioning this room for a party. Thank you very much.